very, very rare 3,000-year-old Egyptian mummified hand, Martian meteorite, woolly mammoth hair, world's smallest jet, genuine shrunken head, cannibal skull, Tibetan skull drum. Now getting out is gonna be interesting. Anything else? I am Edward Meyer. Been with Ripley's, believe it or not, for 37 years. And I went in and seriously didn't know what I was even applying for. It was just cataloging cartoons. That sounds like a good job for a guy who's in library science that wants to, you know, catalog. And I had about a 10-second interview with the then president and owner of the company. He came in and looked at me and said something to the effect, well, you like books? I said, yeah. And he says, okay, well, you can start tomorrow. 169837 gum sculptures. Guy puts a piece of gum, one little single chiclet in his mouth. You ask him for a shape, chews it, and spits out exactly what you want. Robert Ripley died in 1949. At the time of his death, his collection was sold at public auction. Anybody could have bought a Ripley shrunken head or a Ripley Persian carpet. One man named John Arthur had the good sense to buy as much as he could afford. That's really the starting point of Ripley's, believe it or not, as a company. We're now in 65 years since Ripley died. 30 of that 65, the museums that we had were based solely on Robert Ripley's personal artifacts. While in Kathmandu, Nepal, Ripley bought a collection of human bone oddities. This is the very first one. It is an altar bowl made from a human skull. He actually kept it in his house on his coffee table for quite a while. My job is I buy the exhibits we put into our museums. We gotta go out on the road and find it and, you know, verify it before we pay the money. It takes about 500 exhibits to do a Ripley museum. Today, we try very hard to buy 1,000 items a year. This is the International Space Station that's floating above the Earth that everybody hears about, but most people don't know what it looks like. Made from 620,000 matchsticks. Created from blueprints of the actual thing. Every little detail is perfect. At any given time, about 10,000 pieces here. So like 40% of our collection is in the warehouse, 60% in the 31 museums we have around the world. Ultra rare dodo bird skeleton. Shoes of the world's tallest man. I'm gonna put on a fancy glove for this one. Guy from Australia can phone and say, Edward, do you have a shrunken head? And I can say, I got 16, a couple with feathers, I got a couple with long hair, a couple, I'd like the one with long hair and the feathers. Done.